Joshua Hanlon here in Paredes de Cora, Portugal for the LEGO Fan Weekend event, and bring you another group effort interview here where we're going to have a translator and then the builder to talk about this amazing Land Rover build that we have in front of us. So if you would like to introduce yourselves, and then we'll get into the build.
Yeah, my name is Alex. I've been a member of the Auto Chat since the beginning, 2006, and this is Manuel Nascimento. He builds awesome cars, and he's going to talk about a little bit about his creations.
Okay, sounds good. You go ahead and tell us about it.
Okay. Este é o modelo Defender Land Rover 110. Ou melhor dizendo, é o modelo Land Rover Defender 110. Portanto, é station wagon. Eu comecei esta construção mais ou menos em novembro do ano passado. E terminei há cerca de duas semanas, portanto são à volta de 7 meses.
This is the Defender 110 model, the station wagon, and it started in last November and he only finished it 2 weeks ago, so it's almost 7 months of building. It's really a lot.
Yeah. O ano passado comprei uma revista da especialidade e realmente vi que a Defender tinha deixado de produzir, a Land Rover tinha deixado de produzir o modelo Defender, e eu achei que, por bem que ia, gostaria de ficar com uma recordação da Defender na minha coleção.
He bought a magazine last year about these kind of cars, and he noticed that Land Rover would stop producing this vehicle, so he wanted to keep a souvenir, something to remember. And he decided to build a scaled model of this model.
I think this is a pretty incredible souvenir. Can you take us through, you know, the different parts of the build now and point out some of your favorite details?
Okay. So, nós temos o guincho, eu creio que é o Hawk. Funciona. Tem um motor XL a puxar, portanto tem muita força.
Okay, this is the crane with a rope. It really works. It has a power function model, the motor, the XL, so it's really powerful.
Okay, temos tem luzes, piscas, vira as rodas, anda, tem travões. Quando trava, acende a luz de stop.
Okay. Completely light functional. I mean, it has the front lights, the blinkers, the steering wheel as well, and when it brakes, the rear light also. Yeah.
That's impressive.
A parte decorativa tem um extra, pronto, que eu achei engraçado, dado que o tema é um tema de acampamento, colocar uma barraca. Obviamente não é Lego, mas achei que ficaria muito bem.
Okay. Since this is an outdoor vehicle, he thought that it would be really nice to add some other a tent. This is the only element that is not Lego, but he thought it would be really nice to have.
Os pneus não são Lego.
Oh, and this the tires are not Lego. This is the only model, so let's keep it secret.
Okay. Tem uma caixa de velocidades com 4 velocidades. É manual, embora ainda esteja em desenvolvimento.
This one has a gear shift with four, how do you call it, velocities or four gears? Four gears, yeah. But it's still improving the gear.
A nível estético, tentei ser o mais realista possível, recriar todos os detalhes do modelo. Todas as portas funcionam. Eu vou colocar aqui. Tem interiores, portanto, e basicamente é isso, assim, os interiores são mais ou menos recriar o modelo original, e toda a decoração também é mais ou menos a decoração da Camel Trophy.
He tried to add as many real details as he could. All the interiors are like the original model. All the doors open, and all the stickers, for example, they were all inspired in the real model. It's basically as a small version of a real car.
It looks like it.
Okay. Para além do carro, temos um cenário. Mais ou menos um cenário de acampamento em que tentei recriar uma figura mais ou menos à escala para acompanhar o modelo, que realmente acho que era necessário e ficaria bonito.
Since he had a car in a tent, he also decided to make the environment for it, so he made a small camping and he built a person more or less the same scale as a vehicle, just to give a better look to the model.
It makes it even better. And when you're working on the vehicle here, are you looking at kind of photos of the real vehicle or sketches, or how does that work?
Em princípio, eu tento, isto está mais ou menos na escala 1:8. Eu tentei procurar na net, obviamente, medidas do carro real e tentar construir o mais parecido possível com a realidade.
It's more or less the 1:8 scale, and he tried to look for the internet for photos and details and drawings to get as many details as he could so that he could start building.
Mm-hmm. Okay. O carro tem, faço a mínima ideia. Pronto, a nível de tamanho, como já disse, é a escala 1:8. Tirei montes de fotografias da net para tentar, inclusive os interiores, para tentar reproduzir o máximo possível com Lego. Não quer dizer que seja um modelo fechado. A Lego é sempre um mecanismo que conseguimos alterar sempre a todo tempo com peças novas. Por exemplo, as jantes não costumam ser tan, da cor tan, e neste caso a Lego não tem jantes cor tan. Um dia que a Lego lance, obviamente alterarei.
Okay, so according to the drawings and the pictures that he had, he tried to replicate as much as he could be, but it's not a. Although it seems it's not a, for him, it's not a finished model. He's always trying to see something or another detail that he could add or change. For example, the wheels. The real model has the wheels in tan, and this one are in black because Lego doesn't produce them in tan. So he's trying to figure out another solution for them.
And speaking of tan, there is a ton of tan pieces in this build. Were any of those hard to get a hold of, or hard to get as many as you needed for the build?
O carro tem mesmo muitas peças em tan. Alguma delas foi difícil de encontrar, em nível de quantidade?
Sim. Em termos de quantidade, tem algumas peças que são difíceis de encontrar. Os arcos, estes arcos aqui da curvatura da capota, são difíceis de encontrar em quantidade. Outras das peças difíceis de encontrar e que são bastante caras no Bricklink são as plates com clip, mas de resto não tive qualquer dificuldade, a não ser estes dois elementos foram difíceis de encontrar.
There isn't a particular part that is hard to get. The problem is the quantity in part. There were only two parts that were more difficult because of the quantity. It were the several clips one by one in 10. And the slopes on the top of the building, the curved slopes. But otherwise, it was more or less easy to find.
Yeah, well, very interesting.
Eu digo que realmente a capota também, isto depois no final, existe a versão só sem, digamos assim, o display, em que a barraca é desmontável, é colocada num saco aqui. Existe lugar para a escada, okay, também, e toda a estrutura fecha.
A meta também? Vai, tudo está ali
tudo,
também vai?
Tudo, e vai okay. Tudo no carro.
Okay. This is the version, let's say, of the with the camping scene. You can pack and fit everything in the inside of the vehicle. The tent, the mini figure, and the tables and the stairs. Everything you can fit in there.
That is awesome. So it's the whole package. Yeah, you know, you can pack everything up. Very cool.
Like one of those toys that you had, that you bought a car and you had like millions of stuff inside, so that you can play it and stuff it all inside again.
Yeah. Well, I think it's a great build, and I really appreciate both of you working to tell me about it. Thank you. Great job.
Thank us.